In the last module, we had seen how we can install Kali Linux machine. Now the first thing that I would recommend you to do is take a snapshot of your virtual machine. So you can take a snapshot from here. You can select VM and take a new snapshot. And once you click on it, you'll have to name the snapshot. One of the best features of virtual machine is snapshotting. So what basically it allows you to do is, in case you mess up your whole Kali Linux machine, so instead of reinstalling the whole machine, you can directly click on the snapshot over here and you'll be back to the working condition of Kali Linux machine. Now, one of the problems inside the virtual machine is you do not get wireless connectivity. But this is the Wi-Fi hacking and security course, so we do need wireless connectivity inside this virtual machine. So in order to do this, we'll have to buy an additional hardware. It's called a wireless adapter. And for this course, we'll be using this TP-Link W722N based USB adapter. It costs just 700 rupees, so around $12. So I guess most of you will be able to afford it. Now, if you do not have $12, the other alternative to this is you can directly install Kali Linux inside your hard disk drive instead of installing inside virtual machine. Okay, so what I'll do is I have the USB adapter. I plug it inside my laptop. Once I plug it in order to verify, okay, in order to verify, you can either see a new icon over here. It says Atheros USB 2.0 LAN. So this is basically the USB Wi-Fi adapter. What you'll have to do is you'll have to click on here. And here you'll have to click connect. Now it has automatically connected. So what I can do is I can either disconnect and connect it back again. So now, if I try to look over here, it is showing me the wireless connections. And this is all about the connecting wireless adapter. Now, in case for you, if you do not see a wireless adapter, you can either update your operating system using apt-get update and it will install the latest drivers. So most probably, once you apt-get update your system, you'll be able to see the wireless adapter over here. And last thing to verify is, here you can run lsusb command and it will show you Atheros communication. So this is the wireless adapter for my machine that I'm going to use. So this is the short video of how you can connect the external USB adapter to your Linux virtual machine.